And hello, Shock fans, your beloved soldier of the Inverted Cross, back for another Rips Robot Reviews, Robot Mode Reviews. Now, this one is a favorite of mine. I actually have the repaint of it also, but this is the one I use on my main display. It is Transformers Energon. Pretty sure it was Mega Class, or it might have been Ultra. It was when they'd done the $28, $30 figures. Sixshot. I actually scored this guy on Christmas Eve on eBay, like new in box, for a very low price. And I'll go ahead and say this now, like I always say, I don't transform, but this one actually can't transform because, for those of you who know Transformers, Energon might already know this, the mold right here on his, like, this green piece here, there's a metal pin going through it. And the metal pin holds the entire upper body to the from the crotch down on here. And the metal pin usually stresses and breaks the toy in half. So actually, the way to remedy this, because the alt modes aren't spectacular, some glue. I put some super glue in this, and it won't tilt forward. It didn't hinder the articulation or anything. It just guaranteed this figure won't break in half when I try to mess with it. So it's really good. It's supposed to have some lights and sounds in the gun. I don't have batteries in it, and I don't intend on putting any in it because, I mean, the slights and sounds are usually for the younger kids that play with them. But, honestly, I think it would have been better, because this is the only gripe I have about the figure, if they would have taken all the slights and sounds gimmick out and have just put an elbow joint right here so for his arm to, like, bend to point the gun. But, okay, on to articulation. Speaking of that, his head is awesome. It can go left, right, up, down. I mean, he can pretty much do what you want. I think the ears even are poseable a bit. His antenna. Get a good look at the head sculpt. Let's see if it's showing up on my camera. Yep. I like the colors. I know it's not G1 Sixshot, and I'd love to have the third-party Hexatron. It's just a bit expensive. Let's see. The rest of articulation, he does. I'm pretty sure. Let's see. Yeah, he does have a waist joint. Let's see. Make sure I've got that line. This arm has, it can pretty much go full 360. I'm not going to do all that, but it has great ratchets. It ratchets, or doesn't ratchet here. I think it's on a swivel. It comes out here, rotates. There's a like a double elbow here. The thumb can move in and out right here. It's hard to see. I know my camera sucks, but it's, thumb goes in and out. The gun can fold back like this, the double barrels on his arms. But it's, I like to leave those there, like this. This arm, he can rotate up here at the elbow. He can get pretty much in and out. Part of the gimmick, I think this is pretty cool, is if you do this, it opens and all the panels open here. And it shoots the missile, which I'm not shooting the missile. Nope. Never mind, I shot the missile. Freakity frack. Okay. There. Okay, I already did the waist joint. I already said there was that. As far as the legs, he can go... this sunlight messing my camera up. It can go... The ratchets aren't... they're in there. They're ratcheted. I don't know about mine. Let's see. Well, they're just not really loud ratchets. Okay. They can go out pretty far. Thing that can see a knee joint. Yeah, these are just really tight joints. The knee can bend pretty far. There's a swivel in his leg here at his knee, and the feet are pretty cool. They can totally have the, like, it's hard to tell it much, but they can totally, like, do the bendy stuff, like ankle tilts and stuff. And I have the repaint. I own it. And I will grab that for the sake of this review. And I'm back. I didn't die. I'll try to have my repaints in hand before, like, the future reviews. here they both are. It's hard to fit them both in screen. This is just obviously, it's Shock Blast, but it's obviously supposed to be Shockwave. I used this guy as my Transformers Prime Shockwave until Beast Hunter Shockwave came out. And that's why I love the mold so much. I had to get Sixshot just to like put him on that display to have this mold. So yeah, there's another, I can't think if there is another repaint. I don't think there is. There was supposed to be, or Cryotech from Beast Wars was actually based off this mold, his like before Beast mode, but I don't think they ever made it. Pretty sure they didn't. And for size comparison, as always, my trusty Generations Thundercracker, the Seeker mold, everyone probably has it. I'm sure like people who don't even own Transformers, like if they went to their mom's bedroom drawer, there would be probably a Thundercracker or maybe a Starscream in there. Okay, let's go and get to size comparison. He, since he's a Mega, he obviously is a lot bigger than him. So, I mean, he is worth a little more than retail. I wouldn't pay a lot because of the like I said, the issue here that could break. But if you get it new in box and can repair that out of box, because my Shock Blast actually had the cracking in his joint there, you can't really tell it. But, because I glued it and repaired it very well. So, if you can get this thing, it's worth, I would say, in my opinion, I would go up to 50 with it. I would definitely pay 50 bucks for it because it's a nice figure and it really looks, it's big and it looks badass on your shelf. So, that's all for this episode of Rips Robots Reviews. This is your beloved Soldier of the Inverted Cross signing off. Farewell.